kitchen, let's do together the puttu and payar curry. Now we're going to do this as a combination together, like so. First we will make the payar. Let's have a look at the ingredients. I have here the green whole moong, which I have been soaking in the water for about 1 hour. If you don't soak, it won't make any difference. It's just that you will have to cook it longer while. That's all it makes. And then I have here 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces of the garlic. We're going to pressure cook, okay? And I'm going to break in the green chilies. You add as much as green chilies that you want to make your this payar curry spicy. Okay? This my mom makes this curry like this. So, and I'll add a little bit of the curry leaves. And I'm going to pressure cook this very well. I've not added salt. I will just finely pressure cook, and to it I will add this half onion finely chopped also into this, and I will pressure cook this entire stuff. After we pressure cook the moong dal, then we will need to make the gravy with kidney. Okay, I need some coconut oil, salt. I've taken 1 teaspoon of the cumin, some more curry leaves here, 1 tablespoon of the coriander powder, 1/4 teaspoon of the turmeric powder. So as a dal gets cooked, we will go further. I will add in coconut oil, add about 2 tablespoons of the coconut oil. As the coconut oil gets heated, add in the cumin, seeds what we have kept. As it splutters, cumin seeds is fluttering. So now what I'm going to do is add the cooked moong. Okay. Add the turmeric and the coriander powder. Okay. Just left is little bit of the curry leaves that I will add in the end. I'm going to add in the salt and going to give it a good mix. Add as much as water you want. If you're making for chapati, you can keep it little thick. Now there is little more about, this is done around 90%. I like it little more softer, so I'll pour more water. I will cover and cook this very well. Okay, cover, cook, let it just get cooked very nicely. Let it keep boiling, and in the meanwhile we will start to make the puttu. Once the moong is nicely cooked and all the garlic, everything is nicely mushy like, then we will add the curry leaves, and that's all. There is nothing else that you will need for that curry to do. Try making it. If you're making for payar, make it in a thicker form. Don't keep it as water. Unlike puttu, what happens is if the curry is not a little bit of watery, what happens is it's difficult to swallow, right? So that is why we make it a little watery like for the puttu curry like. And one more thing what I have to say here is, like, people who are buying big quantity of the moong dal, what you do is, like, keep half in your fridge. The other half, what you do is just try a little bit roasted and then keep it in your container. So what happens is you will not find any worms or anything which is coming in, or some kind of flying insects which come. All those things will not come. In fact, what I do is whenever I get any of my groceries, like which for moong dal, moong, then that the red bean, all those things which I feel like where there will be lot of these kind of flies which will come, creepers like which will come into the food like. So to these dals which they are attracted and they come like, then what I do is like I roast them like this, and I keep other half, I keep it in the fridge. And once this is over, the next batch I will bring it out. This is how I do it. And then it saves so much of time before we go to work, because reason being, you don't have to stand to fry. Just straight, if you are just, see today if you have seen me, I have not fried this because I've already used the fried one there. If you're having a raw one, you need to first fry and then you have to make the curry. So those are the things you have to keep in mind. So we're going to make the puttu. Now I'm using the ready to make kind of puttu. I'm using the Ajni brand steam puttu podi. I'm using the white puttu podi. Now, whatever the puttu padi, you get all kinds of brands in the market, like you get Nerapara, you get Brahmins. I have tried even the major puttu padi. Everything is nice, but I'm not particular that I want this powder, like for the white puttu, any puttu powder is okay. I have tried using major also, it is nice. So what you can do is, like, you buy anything whatever accessible for you in the nearby market. Another day I will show you how fresh you can make your own, probably for the next puttu when I am making. That time I'll show you how to make. I remember when we were small, how we, those days there is no puttu padi available in the market. What we have to do is soak the rice, then pound the rice, then make the puttu. That used to be a huge task, like, for us. And not only that, after that you have to fry the powder. So all this used to be my task for me to do it, you know, for mom, because mom used to have other kind of work. Anyway, so leaving that part, I will show you all another day how to make that one. So now I will show you, it's not that nobody knows how to make puttu, there's everyone who knows to make puttu. Any Keralite without knowing to make puttu, you cannot find anyone there. But there are people who find it very difficult to make puttu. Some of them say their puttu breaks and it doesn't hold the consistency. So for people who really don't know, who are very beginner like, it's, this is for them, okay? So what I am doing is, I'm going to gently add little by little water and mix this. Now this is the raw rice puttu podi, so it will not absorb much of water, unlike you making in the raw rice. In the boiled rice, the water consumption is too much for the puttu podi. So now you just keep a track of it. I'll show you at what consistency, how you will check your puttu is nicely mixed in water or no, and if it is holding the right consistency. I will show you this now in a while. Mix it well. Okay. We added salt also. If I had not told you all, I've got to say then. That so we just normal puttu podi I opened from the packet and I have put it there and I am starting to bake. Now this is your testing. If you make the normal first puttu podi, you would have seen you cannot hold it, right? It's just very dry, like. Now we see how you are able to hold it, and then you should powder it. That means you are almost in the consistency there, you are almost arrived at the consistency. So now I'll just put the last bit of the water and then, okay, done. Now I will not be adding any more water because this is very soft. Puttu padi is nicely got mixed. Don't add too much of water. If you add too much of water, what will happen is your puttu will become, then you will reach to the kolkata consistency. So mixed here, and then you get to buy this puttu korala. You get like this one, then you have this smaller one. This is for individual portions. Today now I'm making at a stretch for us for dinner, so I thought I will just not make one by one and sit and do it. So I'll make 2 pieces out of this, okay? 2 pieces of puttu in this. So after we nicely mix the puttu powder, we will first add in some coconut. Okay, before I forgot to show you. Okay, I forgot to show. There's kind of a ring here which you need to put, so that blocks this hole here. So there is a hole here, if you can see, it blocks this one, and then we will add in some coconut grated. See, I have added the grated coconut. Then I'm going to add in the rice. See? In case if you are mixing your puttu powder for, you are making for 2 persons now, okay? And there is a lot of puttu podi left, okay? One lot will finish. I'll just explain that part later. Once. Then again, we will put some puttu there. Okay, this is a normal style of puttu what we make in it. In any kada, in any shop that you will see in Kerala, you will see this is how they make. Puttu and kadala, they are the best combination. Another day, I will show you my version of the kadala curry, how I make. We make this also, and then there is another one more curry we make with for puttu to have it. That's something very different. Okay, there is a lid for this here. Okay, like this. Now I have kept in the cooker. This is my normal cooker. What I have done is I have poured water inside. Let me show you all that. See, I poured so much water there inside, okay? And nothing, no ring, nothing. And then the steam is coming here up, okay? Now, we will fix the base. I showed you there is a hole there. That base will go into this. And steam it. Now you will keep it. Now you see that there's two holes here for this. Let me show you. See, there's two holes here. Now there's no steam coming. The moment the puttu is ready, you will start seeing steam coming out of this. That means it will take about 3 to 4 minutes. You will see the steam coming out of it. Just wait for 5 minutes and the puttu is done. When I mix this much of the rice flour is still left off. Now what happens, this rice flour will turn too dry like. Then I'll have to pour some more water, mix it and bring it back to the normal consistency of the puttu. Then only I can make a puttu out of this. Without that you cannot make puttu at all. So that's how you make a puttu. So there's nice steam coming. The puttu is ready already to take it out. I'm going to show you how I'm going to bring it out to the plate. See how the pyre is nicely boiled and ready to serve. And along with that you get a stick like this to buy. When you are buying the puttu molder itself, you get a stick. All you have to do is just push the puttu from with the help of that mold, and there. Steaming hot puttu ready to cool, and along with this we will serve some firewood.